The no return valves or check valves devices are installed on the system that need to control the fluid's flow, specifically to allow fluids to flow only in one direction, avoiding backflow, which is the unwanted water flow in the reverse direction inside the tube. So, this kind of valve prevents any contamination or dispersion of harmful fluids in case of reverse fluid circulation. In this video, we will show how easy it is to build a check valve using very simple materials such as 14mm diameter rubber tube, 20mm diameter rubber tube, 14mm diameter rubber seal, a metal sphere of 10mm in diameter, steel nails, rubber glue, abrasive paper. Let's start by saying that there are different types of no-return valves depending on the purpose of their use. JAES, in its catalog, offers a wide choice of no-return valves types of the major manufacturers. Usually, check valves are formed by a shutter, a spring, and a gasket. The operating principle is very simple. As soon as the fluid pumped into the pipe reaches a pressure value that overcomes the force of the spring, the shutter will open and it will let the fluid flow through. As higher the fluid pressure, as bigger the shutter opening will be. When the pressure value falls below the value that counteracts the force of the spring, the shutter closes, preventing any backflow. An interesting feature of these valves is the possibility to set the valve opening with a specific value, to ensure that the fluid reaches users with a certain pressure value. The valve we are going to create is a no-return ball valve. Well, we notice that the 40mm diameter rubber tube can be inserted inside the 20mm diameter rubber tube. Furthermore, the sphere, which represents the shutter of our no-return valve, has a diameter of 10mm, which allows it to slide into the 20mm tube, but not into the 14mm tube. First, we cut two sections of 6 cm from our 14mm diameter tube. Using the abrasive paper, we make the ends of the two sections rough. Now, we can cut a section of 6 cm in length from our 20mm diameter tube. With a piece of rolled abrasive paper, we roughen the inner surface of the newly created section. We get these three sections of pipe. We take the gasket and we glue it on the end of one of the two 14mm diameter sections. While the glue dries, we glue the other 14mm section into the 20mm section in this way. Then we put a nail inside the 20mm section, more or less at this height. Now, we can place the sphere inside the 20mm tube and we can glue the piece of pipe with the gasket. This is the result we need to achieve. Our no-return valve is completed and is ready to be tested. For the test, we inserted our valve into the end of the remaining 20mm rubber tube, and we inserted a funnel into the other end, created by cutting the neck of a plastic bottle. By inserting the valve in this way, and by letting the water flow inside the tube, we notice that the water flowing through the check valve has a high pressure outlet. This is because the water flowing inside the tube at a certain pressure entering the valve pushes the sphere against the nail. Due to this obstacle, represented by the sphere, the water flows outside our valve at higher pressure. If we try to insert the valve in the opposite direction, we notice instead that only a small amount of water is coming out the pipe. In fact, most of it remains inside the pipe. This is because the water falling into the pipe, entering the valve, pushes the sphere against the outlet tube. The sphere and the gasket create a sort of shutter that block the water from flowing outside the valve. Finally, if you found this video useful, let us know by leaving a comment and subscribing to our YouTube channel to stay tuned on the release of new videos. Thanks for watching.